Today for this joyous occasion. We welcome all of you who have come to be participants in this marriage between Chase and Kristin. As dear friends and family, you have helped to support their relationship from the very beginning, and by witnessing their marriage celebration today, Chase and Kristin ask for you to share in their future as well. Marriage is a big step. It's a covenant, and it's a promise to always be faithful, to always be kind, to always be supportive, no matter the situation. It can only work if both partners promise to always protect one another, to always listen, to always love each other in an unconditional manner. And it is important that Chase and Kristin always share with each other and listen openly without fear, trusting that together you will find the right path when you're unsure of the way. So it is into this state that Chase and Kristin wish to enter. Throughout time and tradition all over the world, it has been the distinct honor and privilege for someone to present the bride in marriage. So today, who presents Caitlin in marriage? Kristin too.
Her mother, Sheila, and then myself, her father.
Fantastic. We are gathered here today to witness the coming together of two people whose hearts and spirits are already entwined as one. In fact, those of you who know Chase and Kristin best can also attest to their love for one another and to their blended hopes, dreams, and goals that they share. Will you please be seated? When such a bond exists of this magnitude, then it is only appropriate that we have an open public demonstration of their love, such as this wedding ceremony today. And so it is that Chase and Kristin now will profess before God, their family, and their friends of their desire to henceforth walk this road of life together. From the book of Genesis, it says, "For God created man in his own image. Then the Lord formed man of dust from the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living being. Then the Lord God said, 'It is not good that man should be alone. I will make a helper fit for him.' So the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and while he slept, he took one of his ribs, he closed up its place with flesh, and the rib which the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. Then the man said, 'This at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man.' Therefore a man leaves father and mother and cleaves to his wife, and the two become one flesh." And so today we gather to celebrate that same type union. Do you, Chase, knowing of this woman's love for you and returning it, realizing her strengths and learning from them, recognizing her weaknesses and accepting them, take Kristin to be your lawfully wedded wife? If so, will you please say, "I do"?
I do.
Do you, Kristin, knowing of this man's love for you and returning it, realizing his strengths and learning from them, recognizing his weaknesses and accepting them, take Chase to be your lawfully wedded husband? If so, will you please say, "I do"? Will you pray with me? God, bless these hands that you see before you this day. May they always be held by one another. Keep them tender and gentle as they nurture each other in their wondrous love. Help these hands to continue building a relationship founded in your grace. May Chase and Kristin see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. We ask this in your name. Amen. Chase and Kristin, as you pledge your vows to each other, let me remind you that no other words are more sacred, no other words are more tender than those you are now about to assume. May these vows only be broken by death, and may you both live a very, very long and healthy life together. As a symbol of your union, you've joined hands. I would like for you to look into the eyes of the one you love, and please repeat after me. Chase, you first. I, Chase, take you, Kristin, as my friend and my love.
I, Chase, take you, Kristin, as my friend and my love.
Beside me and apart from me.
Beside me and apart from me.
In laughter and in tears.
In laughter and in tears.
In conflict and in tranquility.
In
conflict.
Conflict and tranquility.
Asking that you be no other than yourself.
Asking you that you be no other than yourself.
Loving what I know of you.
Loving what I know of you.
Trusting what I do not know.
Trusting what I do not know.
And in all the ways that life may lead us.
And in all the ways that life may lead us.
Hi, Kristin. I, Kristin, take you chase as my friend and my love.
I, Kristin, take you chase as my friend and my love.
Beside me and apart from me.
Beside me and apart from me.
In laughter and in tears.
In laughter and in tears.
In conflict and in tranquility.
In conflict and in tranquility.
Asking that you be no other than yourself.
Asking that you be no other than yourself.
Loving what I know of you.
Loving what I know of you.
Trusting what I do not know.
Trusting and what?
Trusting what I do not know. And in all the ways that life may lead us.
In all the ways that life may lead us.
Okay, that's all right. You did good. Rings. Get your rings. Yeah. She's juggling. Get it right there. Right there. Awesome. Chase and Kristin, as you prepare to exchange rings here, these two rings are made of precious metals and gems. And they represent the precious love between the two of you. They are also circular to represent the unbroken circle of love. For love that is freely given has no beginning and it has no end. May these rings always remind you that your love is never ending too. May God bless these rings and the two of you who wear them. May you always abide in His peace and continue in His favor. Amen. Chase, please take Kristin's ring. Place it on her left ring finger to seal your commitment of love and repeat after me. Kristin, with this ring.
Kristin, with this ring.
I commit to you.
I commit to you.
As this ring encircles your finger.
As this ring encircles your finger.
Always be reminded.
Always be reminded.
My love encircles your heart.
My love encircles your heart.
Kristin, please take Chase's ring and place it on his left ring finger to seal your commitment of love and repeat after me. Chase, with this ring, I commit to you.
Chase, with this ring, I commit to you.
As this ring encircles your finger.
As this ring encircles your finger.
Always be reminded.
Always be reminded.
My love encircles your heart.
My love encircles your heart.
Good job. Okay, thanks. The Unity Cross signifies the wedding covenant. It is a lasting reminder of the bride and the groom coming together with your faith in Christ, beginning your life journey as one. I'm going to encourage you as we put this together that you place this in a place of prominence in your home so that you'll always be reminded who is the focal point of your marriage. Stay there, just stay there. Yeah. The bold outer cross represents the groom. He is the strength and the cover for his family and his home. Yet, without his bride, as you can see, it is incomplete. The intricate inner cross represents the bride. Beautiful, multifaceted, she brings her creative abilities and wisdom. The couple bring their hearts and faith in Christ together, joining their pieces of the Unity Cross and demonstrating their commitment to each other. The three pegs that they will use to put this together represents the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Put it together first. There you go. Now that the sculpture is complete, the two shall become one. Let that also be a reflection that life is tough and things do come your ways that together you all can accomplish. Heavenly Father, thank you for allowing us this opportunity to be present in these surroundings where dreams come true, where a couple comes together in marriage. Thank you for Chase and Kristin as they begin this, their journey through life together. Walk with them each step of the way, giving them the faith and the wisdom to face together whatever the future may hold. In your name we pray, amen. The book of Ruth says, "Entreat me not to leave you or from walking beside you. For where you go, I will go. Where your home shall be, my home will be. Your family shall be my family. Your friends shall be my friends. And most importantly, your God shall be my God." As you, Chase, and Kristin have pledged your vows, you've consented to wed to each other, you've consecrated this celebration with the giving and accepting of the wedding rings. By the virtue of the authority vested in me under the laws of our beautiful state of Tennessee, I now have the privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. Chase, you may kiss your beautiful bride. Take your bouquet and face that way. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise as I present to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Reynolds. Grandparents, they've asked that you all remain where you are. Grandparents, if you all can keep on going, that'll be great. And you all can follow. Just reading the notes. Guests, your presence is requested on a reception honoring their wedding and their marriage together. And you all may exit through that door right over there, and they'll be with you shortly. God bless you. Thank you for coming.